Well, welcome to a Holy Saturday devotion. We're in this moment, this quiet moment of living in the hope of the resurrection. I thought I'd bring out a little Cubs attire today because I'm living in the hope that there's going to be a baseball season this year. What happened on Holy Saturday? Not very much. The disciples were locked up for fear of the Jews. Everyone was resting. It's interesting, isn't it, that this was the day that Jesus rested in the tomb. Think about it. He had his own Shabbat. And just as he was rested after he said, "It is finished, it's completed," he rested from all his work prior to the resurrection. But there are other things going on too. And I want to read a little bit from Matthew chapter 27 at the end of the gospel story about the crucifixion, these words to give you a hint as to what's going on. "And behold," it says in Matthew 27, verse 51, "and behold, the curtain in the temple was torn in two from the top to the bottom." That means that it's God tearing it in half, not people ripping it up from the bottom. "It's torn in two from top to the bottom, and the earth shook, and the rocks were split, and the tombs also were opened." And here's that strange story. "And many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised." You know, what they did at that time was they put a body in the tomb for a year. And on the year anniversary of the death, they went in and they collected all the bones and they put them into a little box called an ossuary. And then they would go and they would bury that elsewhere. But what a strange thing. All these saints that were lying in the tomb were raised. And they're coming out of the tomb after his resurrection. They went into the holy city and appeared to many. That at the moment of Christ's resurrection, it was as if God was saying, "I want to put an extra seal on this. I want everybody to know that not only is he resurrected, but there's a hope. There's a hope for the resurrection and a hope for all of us." Isn't that a beautiful thing to think about on Easter Saturday? That while we are in this present waiting time, just as those who were the saints who had fallen asleep were in their waiting time, God's thinking about them. And the power of the resurrection will not only raise up our bodies, but it can raise up all of our spirits too. This quiet time when the disciples for sure were grieving and wondering, they're in shock as to what had happened. They were hidden away, perhaps. We know that the next day they were hidden away because they were afraid that it might happen to them too. And into that moment, Jesus breaks. And so I want you to be thinking about that today. Be thinking about what happens when Jesus breaks into a bad situation. Oh, will he be there for all of us? Oh, will he strengthen everyone who's afraid? You just put your trust in the Lord with all your heart. Don't lean on your own understanding. In all your ways, that means in your coronavirus ways, in your worried about food ways, in your worried about infection ways, in your worried about your job or your business ways, in all your ways, acknowledge him and he'll take care of it. He'll make your path straight. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you for the resurrection, and we thank you for the resurrection of the saints that Matthew talked about. Remind us that there is yet a resurrection and that there is yet a hope, and that when we are hopeless, even when we are dead in our sins, dead in our trespasses, you make us alive in Christ. And so strengthen us for this day and give us your peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, yesterday was a longer devotion. Today is a shorter devotion. It's a chance for us to all prepare for that great celebration around the empty tomb. Make sure that you're watching this weekend, and make sure if you're watching on Facebook, you can invite others, you can have a watch party, encourage everybody, because this is a time and this is a day where while we can't meet together, we can certainly share the good news, a hope that we have in Jesus. And by inviting people to watch with you, it's a beautiful way for you to express the hope that you have. We'll see you at the empty tomb. God bless you today and every day.